Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to take a look at a unique way to create animation in iClone by using the lookat constraint. You can use this feature in a variety of situations to easily direct a character's attention and create smooth transitions between areas of focus. It allows us to easily create interactive animations for characters and objects. Let's start off with the basic functionality of camera lookat and picking a lookat target. With your character selected, you want to start off by opening up the lookat section of the modify panel. You'll see an option for look at camera and pick target, which allows you to pick an object of focus. Let's start our first example by choosing look at camera, and our character will snap to look at our currently used camera. Once this constraint is active, we can move our camera around and our character's attention will follow the camera movement. This is the most basic type of look at constraint that gives off a bit of a creepy vibe in a lot of cases. Let's try one case where we can pick a target. Here I have a dummy object next to my character, and I'm going to select that after clicking Pick Target. You'll notice that the character's eyes, head, and even body will snap to focus on the dummy. If you move the dummy object around, you'll see a natural progression of movement from the head to the body as they both follow along. In the weight section, you'll see sliders for head and body strength, which will affect how strongly each respective part is influenced by the lookat constraint. If these values are set to 0, then only the eyes will follow along with the movement of the dummy object. There is also a slider for associated eyebrow movement. When this parameter has a high value, you'll see more concentration on the object as indicated by the stronger eyebrow focus. This allows for another layer of intensity of your look at that wasn't previously available. Finally, there's also an option to enhance your CC character with head turn morphs, which adds to the overall effect by adding more detail via blend shapes dedicated to the interaction between head and body appearance when rotating. You can see the difference here when enhance head turn morphs is enabled. Aside from head and body weight, you can also adjust the weight of the individual axes to determine the tilt of your character's body. You can see the effects here as I adjust the various parameters under the body axis weight section. Keep in mind that you can also keyframe these values to customize the effect even more. Okay, let's look at using the timeline to create lookat transitions for natural movement and changes in focus. Here we have a romantic Kevin playing the guitar for his paramour, and we want him to look at her while he's doing so, just in a more natural and less creepy way. Let's start by assigning a simple lookat constraint on the female by having her look at Kevin's head using the pick target option. We can tweak the body axis weight values, adjust the camera view, and play back to see how it looks. With Kevin, we're going to get a bit more in-depth. I'm going to start by going a bit further down the timeline and activating the same look at target around frame 280. I'll initially take the head and body values down to 0 so only his eyes are looking at her. Then a little bit further down, increase the head strength as he gradually starts to focus more of his attention. Notice that it will create a keyframe in the respective track. I can double-click in the body track to add a keyframe there as well, and then add a couple more keyframes the same way on both tracks around frame 400. At frame 430, I'll move the head slider strength up a bit more, which will again automatically create a keyframe. I'll leave the body track empty of keyframes for now, and then manually add one at frame 500 further down. At 530, I'll finally add some strength to the body, and you'll see his torso tilt towards the girl. By adjusting the weight values at different times throughout the project, you can create a much more natural progression of focus throughout the interaction as opposed to a mechanical and almost robotic effect. We highly recommend that you disperse your weight values more gradually as opposed to all at once to make the focus change appear much more natural and smooth. That's really all there is for this tutorial, guys. Be sure to check out our other videos on our Realism courses page, and I'll see you in the next one.